5. It says that this person came saying, three loaves I need. Because of this friend I want to serve. It's not even a personal need, really. It's the need of the other person that I need to serve. And then he says, trouble me not. Then he says, though he will not rise and give him because of his friend, yet because of his importunity, he will rise and give him as many as he needeth. And today, if you are going to hold on in the spirit of faith, the Lord will give you as much as you need. And I say unto you, ask, and it shall be given you. Seek, and you shall find. Knock, and it shall be opened unto you. For everyone, are you part of that? Say everyone. Say, I'm going to receive. Because everyone that asketh receiveth. Say it aloud. Because everyone that asketh receiveth. And he that seeketh findeth, and to him that knocketh, it shall be opened. Now it says, if a son shall ask bread of any of you, that say, Father, will he give him a stone? No. Or if he ask a fish, will he give for a fish a serpent? No. If he ask an egg, will he offer him a scorpion? No. If he then being evil, no. How to give good gifts to your children? How much more shall your heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to them that ask him? How much more? How much more? How much more? It's a great day. And it's the day of your breakthrough. It's the day of solution to your problem. It's the day of the moving of your mountain. But you must hold on in the spirit of faith. Matthew chapter 15. Reading from verse 21. Then Jesus went thence and departed into the coasts of Tyre and Sidon. And behold, a woman of Canaan came out of the same coasts and cried unto him, saying, have mercy on me, O Lord, thou son of David. My daughter is grievously vexed with the devil. But he answered her, not a word. Remember, even when it appears the answer has not come, keep on holding on in the spirit of faith. He answered her not a word. And his disciples came and besought him, saying, send her away, for she cries after us. Even when men or women or people, even if when they seem to be contrary to you, opposed to you, as if they want to hinder your blessing, keep on holding on in the spirit of faith. And then we're told, but he answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel. Even when it appeared, the promise you are trying to stand on, the devil is saying, that promise is not for you. And Bible interpreters are saying, that promise is not for you. That is not for this dispensation. It is not for a Gentile. It's for the children of Israel. Even when they are saying that, you hold on in the spirit of faith. Then she came and worshipped him, saying, Lord, help me. But he answered and said, it is not me to take the children's bread and cast it to dogs. Even when the Lord himself is saying, you are not worthy. Because look at the dog, look at your life, look at the past, look at your life, look at your behavior, look at your life. You still keep on holding on. Lord, whatever you want me to correct, I will correct. But help me, deliver me, set me free, hold it on in the spirit of faith. And then she said, it is not me to give the children's bread and cast it to the dogs. She said, truth, Lord, yet the dogs eat of the crumbs which fall from their master's table. Then Jesus answered and said unto her, O woman, great is thy faith. Be it unto thee as thou wilt. And her daughter was made whole from that very hour. This is your own hour. This is your own time. Remember, you have the spirit of faith already. Let it come out. Confess it. Proclaim it. And stand on the unchanging word of the Almighty God. Don't allow any hindrance, the spirit of fear, the spirit of error, the spirit of Christ, the spirit of unbelief, the spirit of divination, the spirit of the world, the spirit of slumber, or the spirit of self-will, the spirit of unbelief. Don't let that come in. This is your day, and this is your hour, and the miracle and the blessing you have been spent for a long time, fulfillment is going to come. And you keep on holding on until it is done. It will be done. Why don't you rise up? Why don't you rise up now? And with the spirit of faith, with the spirit of faith, this is the hour of prayer. This is the time of prayer. Don't you have a need? Don't you have a request? Don't you have a prayer item? Don't you have something you want the Lord to do for you? This saying, oh Lord, I come with the spirit of faith. The spirit of faith like Caleb's faith, like David's faith, like Elisha's faith, the spirit of faith like the men of old. And I'm not going to allow any hindrance at all. Well, the same spirit of faith, and therefore we'll shout aloud, and therefore we'll cry aloud, and therefore we'll speak unto this mountain, be thou removed, and it will be gone. The same spirit of faith, I will overcome. The same spirit of faith, we are well able. The same spirit of faith, I am healed. The same spirit of faith, my mountains are taken away. The same spirit of faith, my servant is healed. My husband is healed. My wife is healed. My children are healed. The same spirit of faith, I've got the job. The same spirit of faith, the Lord is answering my prayers right now. The same spirit of faith, don't allow the Antichrist to oppose the word of God or the will of God or the promise of God in your life. The same spirit of faith, the same, the same, the same, the same spirit of faith. It will get you healing. It will get you deliverance. It will get you the power you need. It will give you the authority. It will give you the might of the Lord. The same spirit of faith. Don't allow error. Don't allow the Antichrist. Don't allow divination. Don't allow the ceremonies of false religion to hinder you. The same spirit of faith. Open your mouth and tell the Lord. Be like Abraham, catching the seas which be not as though they were. Catching the seas which be not as though they were. The healing is there. The deliverance is there. The provision is there. All the promises of God are yes and amen to the people having the same spirit of fear, the same spirit of faith. Believe that this is your day and this is your hour. The hour of victory, the hour of deliverance, and the hour of the manifestation of the power of God in your life, on your behalf. The time has come. The day has come when the Lord himself, if you are holding on, holding on, holding on with the spirit of faith, the day has come, the hour has come when the Lord himself will honor your faith. Remove the mountain. Break every yoke and destroy the works of the devil. We are having the same spirit of faith. We having the same spirit of faith. This is the time and the place of prayer. Don't allow a man, a woman with the spirit of divination to come across your way, or to hinder you, or to make you lose your hold on the power of the Lord, on the provision of the Lord, on the promise of the Lord. The same spirit of faith. Move on, move on, move on away from those hindrances, and get what the Lord has given you today. This day will be your day of breakthrough, your day of miracle, the day of power, and the day when the Lord himself, by his mighty manifestation, will manifest his power in your life. This is the day. Let it be. Let it be. Let it be. Let it be. And speak in the spirit of faith. We believe, and therefore speak. We believe, and therefore speak. In Jesus' name we pray. How many people are trusting the Lord today, and you are standing there in the spirit of faith, knowing that faith cannot fail, and you are not allowing fear in your heart, for God has not given us the spirit of fear, but has given us the spirit of love, of power, and of a sound mind. And because we stand on the unchanging promises of the unchanging God, we know he is going to answer our prayer. And we know that this will be the day when those mountains collapse and they get away and they flee away from your life in Jesus' name. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we pray today that all the problems that have confronted us from our birth until this time, they collapse and they get away from us in Jesus' name. We already today have the spirit of faith, and we declare it is well in Jesus' name. We proclaim we are huge in Jesus' name. We declare we have overcome in Jesus' name. Lord, we have in the spirit of faith. We believe, and therefore we speak today that blindness is cancelled in Jesus' name. That all those attacks and the arrows of the enemy, today they are cancelled. Today they are broken. Today they are destroyed in Jesus' name. Oh Lord, upon any brother, any sister, any man, any woman, any boy, any girl there, I pray you touch them now. And Lord, I declare with the spirit of faith that they are healed in Jesus' name. They are delivered in Jesus' name. And the power of Satan is broken from their lives in Jesus' name. Everyone hearing the sound of my voice now, I pray that the miracle power of God will flow into their bodies now. All mountains in their lives, you roll away in Jesus' name. Confirm it, O Lord. Confirm it, O Lord. Confirm it, O Lord. And let there be shout of praise in the camp of the people of God in Jesus' name. We accept the answer. We receive the miracle. We take it right now. And we're going to keep on holding on in this spirit of faith. We'll never be denied in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father, because we know that you have answered. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray.